El negocio es pegar, pique.
The business is to land punches. He's right in front of you. You gotta throw punches. You know, he's not running from you. He's right in front of you.
He's slowing down now. I need him to step up.
Get in here. Get in here.
Come on, Pete.
Come on. Okay.
Now you're looking very good out there. Keep it going.
Okay.
5 seconds out.
You're looking at a master craftsman who is just walking right in to the eye of a big hurricane and surviving and thriving.
Pineda's corner told him, they're not going to give you that decision. Believe me, he's not doing anything to make them give it to him. He needs a knockout.
Giving you a sense of how extraordinarily heavy the body punching has now become between these 240 pounders. Right hand lands for Pineda. Whitaker fires right back.
Uses his eyes to perfection. Watches the whole body of Pineda.
You think of fighters like Muhammad Ali and Ray Leonard, who seem to see everything in the ring.
They see everything. It's a gift. The big punchers, they only watch the head of the opponent. They don't pay much attention to the hand or the feet. Just the head. That's all they want.
Just so gifted.
Good right hand by Pineda.
He's had a couple of them in this round. Once again, Pineda holding behind the head and hitting Whitaker. Now, in this round, the right eye of Pineda, not nearly as swollen as the left one early in the bout, has begun to swell around the outer edge. And that's the product of those straight left hands that Purnell has used so effectively.
Body shot.
Down goes Pineda.
A right hand to the body. Does he want to get up? Yes, he does.
He quit against Breland, but that was in a bout against 147-pounder when he was taking extraordinary amounts of punishment.
When you get hit in the body like that, it takes your breath away.
Oh. Low blow.
So does that.
Round bell comes to an end.
Take a point away, for Christ's sakes!
Nuva yelling at Cortez to take another point away.
Sit down.
And Cortez does. One more point taken away from Pineda. Largely immaterial at this point anyway.
Exactly.
That gets you into the fight.
Intentional, I can tell you that. To me, he's going for the body. And if it happened, it went down and because Whitaker fist
it may not have been intentional, George, but I think he wanted to retaliate for the punch that put him down. Here you'll see a right to the ribs, and that's the one.
It
may have knocked the breath out of him for a moment, but he did retain his composure.
That's a punch that hurt.
And now they come back to begin round 9. And remember, we are barely a minute and 10 seconds past the point at which Whitaker was felled by a low blow, and that came shortly after Pineda was taken down by the right hand of the ribcage that you saw. So both fighters may still be feeling the effects a little bit as round 9 begins. Whitaker goes back to stand up moving to his right.
It's not an easy thing to take a title away from a guy.
Another low blow. And Cortez has to be very close to disqualification here. It's not going to mean much to keep taking points away when Pernell is...
That wasn't a low blow.
So far ahead, huh?
That was not a low blow. It was thrown right at the body, and his elbows is bringing those punches over. He's trying to cross his elbow over to knock him forward.
Well, at least he sold Cortez on the notion that it was a low blow, George.
Right. You got to be careful with that.
Just a little bit. Rafael's punch is getting wilder and wilder now.
He's not giving up on that right uppercut. No matter how he misses with it, he continues to throw it.
The knockdown of Pineda, incidentally, was, he says, according to what he's told us, the first time he's ever been knocked to the canvas, professional or amateur. We have no way of confirming that because the overwhelming majority of his fights are in Barranquilla and Cartagena, Colombia. Their record keeping isn't what we might hope and dream it would be.
Whitaker stepping maybe three steps backwards, inviting Pineda to come forward, and when he does, he catches him with a straight left hand.
And that time, Pernell slipped on a wet spot on the canvas. And Cortez rules it a slip and calls time. And now he wants the wet spot wiped up in the corner.
The fighter spit too much in the corner, if you ask me.
I get the impression that Whitaker could catch birds with those fast hands.
There you see the fast hands as he delivers, and steps away. Pernell giving the crowd a little touch of everything now. He has been known when escaping from punishment to whirl all the way around his opponents and tease them from behind their backs.
A lot of times your trainers will tell you, hold the hit and hit him sometimes.
No.
But you wouldn't do anything like that, George.
I've got to ask Coach.
All right, now just keep it going just like that. You understand? Don't change up. Keep him looking for you. Keep sticking him and stabbing him.
Pete, this guy's desperate now, and the sand is going to try anything. You box the way you're supposed to box.
So have your hands up good now. Just keep sticking and stabbing and making him miss, right? Make him miss. When you can make him pay, you can make him pay.
Harold Letterman, give us your scorecard.
Larry, 9-0, 90-78, overwhelming for Pernell Whitaker. There's no question in my mind, round 8 was an interesting round. Pernell gets one extra point for the knockdown, one extra point for the low blow, so that makes it a 10-7 round in the 8th. Pernell winning the fight easy. I mean, Joe Cortez is very, very close to disqualifying Rafael Pineda. He's warned him, taken away 2 points, and warned him numerous times.
Yeah, but it's very hard to disqualify a champion, and particularly when the punches are not deliberate.
Incidentally, the trunks do belong where the belly button is. Generally, if the trunks are where the belly button is, the referee will call it low if it's below the waistband.
Now, a lot of times, it seems like he's holding this fella, but Whitaker is moving right into that left jab of his, and it just lays on his shoulder, seemingly like he's holding it.
Recovered from the effects of the body punch that knocked him to the floor in round 8. Firing with abandon again. Pineda's still relatively busy for him, as Pernell has given him more of a target than he might have expected. But in coming inside, Pernell has given himself the chance to land with a lot of solid shots. Shots of the kind he hadn't thrown as many of against fighters like Jorge Paez and Harold Brazier, and they have been relieved. relentlessly effective. Good right hand by Pineda.
Whitaker is using the old tight circle. He moves backwards but to the side to give the impression that you're moving away. You circle him but keep him close.
As you watch Pernell Whitaker for the moment handling a heavy puncher like Pineda, and you have to speculate, what if he were to get a chance in this weight class against the great Julio Cesar Chavez?
Well, Chavez is not a one-punch puncher. He's just a great, relentless fighter. But obviously, if this fight continues that way, that's the fight.